Hi, my name's Mark Court from BoatUS Magazine. Today I'm going to be showing you how to change the fuel filter on a diesel engine. On a diesel engine there's usually two fuel filters. This one, which is the one we're concerned with today, which is the primary fuel filter, and then we have a secondary fuel filter up here actually on the engine. This is the filter that gets clogged up the soonest, because the fuel comes from the tank, goes through this filter and then goes to the engine. So if we have an issue, this is the one that we need to concentrate on. So if the engine was sputtering or it was hard to start and we suspect the fuel problem, then we'd come here and we'd look at this first. So I'm going to go right ahead and do that, but before I do that, there's a couple of safety items I need to mention. You'll see I'm wearing rubber gloves, I've got a rag, and I've got some oil absorbent pads below the filter, because we are going to spill some fuel. You don't really want to get this stuff on your hands. Apart from the fact it stinks, it's probably not a good idea. So let me go ahead. So I'm going to go ahead now and unscrew the top of the filter. Sometimes a bit tight. I should mention that there are other types, but this is by far and away the most common type. This is actually a Raycore filter. They do come in different sizes. We have a fairly small four-cylinder diesel on this boat, but if you have a larger diesel, then the fuel filter itself would be bigger. So I've loosened that off. I'm going to take the top off. The top comes off. This is an aluminium casing, and you'll see inside here there's a rubber O-ring. We need to take that out. And that's always a bit tricky to get out, so we need to get under that with a screwdriver and lever that out, because we're going to be replacing that at the same time as a filter. I've got a bag here, so all the scrap parts I'm going to put in the bag so we don't spill fuel in the boat. I'll put that to one side, and then there is actually little lifting rings on this, so we'll lift that up and lift the filter out. Now the filter, actually this one's pretty clean, as you can see. It's obviously recently been changed. This is actually a 30 micron filter. The micron refers to the size of particulate that it will actually trap. This is a 30. I personally favour a smaller micron size because it traps more stuff. But it does mean that you will need to change the filter more often. So I'm going to put that aside. So now we've got the filter out of the way, it's worth looking inside, because you can see that we've got some dirt in here, right in the bottom. This is a turbine style filter. So what that means is that as the fuel goes through the filter, it swirls around, and any dirt and large particles get left at the bottom. It's actually not too bad, but I'm just clearing that out of the way a little bit with a screwdriver. So now we can go ahead and put the new filter in there. Okay, so now I'm opening up the new filter. These do come in different sizes, as I mentioned earlier. This is a 2 micron filter, and it's stamped on the top there, and actually they're also in different colors. So this is in maroon, and I believe that a 10 micron is in blue. So you can tell even if you can't read the writing. So as you can see, that's nice and clean. So we're gonna go ahead and we're going to drop that in there. But before we do that, also in the bag, we've got a number of parts that we need. Put that to one side. Be careful not to drop these in the bilge of the boat, it would ruin your day. So there's a little rubber ring there. And we've got another couple of O-rings. We'll come back to that in a second. But what happens with this is that there are two types of these filters. This is just an older version of the same thing. If you see in the bottom there, we've got a little castellated molding, and then we've got this rubber here. What happens with that is the rubber slips over there, and then the filter drops on. That stops it going down too far into the filter body. If you look at the old one, if you can see that through the plastic, this is the newer style, and it has the plastic already connected there. So if you buy this, that you don't have that rubber ring, but they're both interchangeable with one another. This is the new style. You're going to start to see a lot more of these now. So the other one type is being phased out. So that's sitting in there now. So now I'm going to go back to my packet, take out the large rubber ring, and I'm going to sit that back down in here. You have to be very careful that you do not twist this. If you get a twist in the rubber, you will get a leak. So that will sit back on top there. We can put that on. And there's one final O-ring in here. That's this little red ring. Put that down here for a second. And what that does, if you look at the old T-nut off the top there, you'll see that there's one around here. So we need to pry that off first. So pull that off. That gets discarded too. And put the new one on. It's a bit of a stretch, but you can roll that on. So now I'm just going to put the T-nut back on. I've reseated the new little O-ring on there, as you can see. We screw that back in the top, making sure that this is seated properly. And this T-nut only needs to be hand tight. There's no need to put a wrench on that. More than one time I've seen these where these actually cracked the top because they've been over tightened, because this is only cast aluminum. Now that we've done that, we're all good to go. The only thing we've got to do is go ahead and bleed the engine, and we'll show that to you in a separate video, which you can find at boatus.com/magazine. Thanks for watching.